So to many people, the idea that you could be damaging your engine by driving all the time at very low RPMs is a completely alien concept. But the reality is that you can cause significant damage to your engine if all you do is low RPM driving. The video we did a little while ago about driving at the red line really recommended using the red line now and then. So in this video, it's really flipping it on its head, and we're going to look at the low end of the RPM range, and we're going to look at what happens if you always use your car at low RPM. Now, there is nothing wrong with doing periods of driving at low RPMs. Indeed, if you want fuel economy, that's what you should be doing. But the key takeaway from the end of this video really is that we should vary our driving. Let's look at some of the problems that can happen with this consistent low RPM driving and understand what's going on inside our engine so that we can avoid the potential problems and pitfalls of this. Now, it varies very much from engine to engine. Different engine designs, whether it's got a turbocharger, a modern engine with a modern ECU, or an older carb-driven engine, are very, very different. So there is a wide range of opinions that are going to arise on this subject. But we're just going to look at a baseline, something that could potentially affect most cars and most drivers out there. So there's really two areas of concern. The first is driving at low RPMs using a wide open throttle. That's a situation that hypermilers often find themselves in because they keep the RPMs as low as possible with their brain thinking low RPMs means I'm using very little fuel, and that's really their aim. And then they get to a situation where they need to accelerate or overtake something or get out of the way of trouble, and they don't have time to change gear. Obviously, if you've got an automatic, it's completely different. Most drivers over here have a manual transmission, so this is probably very much a UK oriented video, but there's certainly takeaways that apply around the world. But in that situation, putting your foot full on the throttle, you're going to cause excessive wear and tear on your engine. And we're going to discuss those in this video. The other aspect we're going to look at is consistent low RPM driving. So not really using full throttle, but dribbling around everywhere. We might call that grannying the car. And that's a driving style that's been adopted by many that are seeking to save fuel. But after this video, you've got to ask yourself the question, will the cost of repairs that I'm running up on my car outweigh the cost of fuel that I've saved? So it could be a different approach that you need to take to driving. So firstly, your engine has been designed to work in a set RPM range to deliver power and economy and reliability at a set RPM range. So if you drive consistently outside of what the manufacturer intended, you're going to put extra strain and wear and tear on the engine itself. So imagine you're on a bicycle and you're riding up a hill. You know how much extra effort it takes if you're in the wrong gear. It really does take a lot of strength to move the bike. And indeed, in the car engine, the laws of mechanics still apply to that. If you're in the wrong gear, the engine is working overtime. You're going against the mechanical advantage and causing all sorts of extra stress and strain in the engine. We're going to dissect that a little and just look at what's going on inside the engine. So this is often referred to as lugging the engine. So you're driving at low RPMs. Now, the combustion event takes place effectively at the same speed at whatever RPM you're driving at. So the rate of expansion going on inside the combustion chamber, it's the same whether the piston is moving slowly or it's moving quickly. So what happens at low RPMs is it's closer to top dead center. The force is pushing against the piston and the rod is not in the best position to take advantage of that power. In fact, it's pushing sideways because the angle the rod is at, and that's going to cause excessive wear and tear on those engine components. Whereas if you're driving at higher RPMs, the load on the piston, rod and crank is spread over a larger distance effectively because it's traveling further during that combustion event. So this piston slap where the piston is moving against all the force can result in you burning oil. It can put excessive wear on the cylinders, the cylinder walls, the pistons, the piston rings, and it can lead to you burning oil and can cause a run-on of other problems that develop. So you really do want to avoid using power at low RPMs when you're driving. So in turbocharged engines, you've also got the risk of low speed pre-ignition, which can cause serious damage to the engine, but we're not going to be discussing that in detail in this video. It's really another topic to be discussed in another video as I dissect that and we get to grips with what causes low speed pre-ignition. So also in this low RPM where you're using power, the piston's moving more slowly. So that energy has to go somewhere, and it's got more of a tendency to create blow by where it's rushing past the gaps between the piston rings and the cylinder wall. And that can have effects on the overall crankcase pressure. The PCV is going to try hard to maintain that crankcase pressure. It's going to be venting more of those vapors from inside the engine into the engine's intake. Well, that can lead to deposits forming on the valves themselves. You can also think about the computer working. So at 1000 RPMs, the engine is rotating 1000 times every minute. Whereas at 5000 RPMs, you've got five times the opportunity, five times the calculations are going on, and you've got five times the opportunity to trim things and just make sure that the fuel and the spark and everything is happening at the right moment. So the engine is going to be more efficient. It's going to be smoother running outside of those low RPM regions. So that's a big one, really, to avoid flooring the throttle at low RPMs. You're going to cause damage to your car. Now, some modern engines have certain mitigations in place. They protect the engine from stupid, which is a good thing in my book, but some engines don't have that degree of protection. And we do still see occasionally seriously damaged cars, which give evidence that this low speed pre-ignition or premature ignition or something has gone wrong, and it's down to this high throttle, low RPM driving style. So now just talking about general low RPM driving all the time. Now, your engine needs lubrication. We've done so many videos on engine oil and lubrication. Now, what happens is the oil pump and the water pump inside the engine is connected to the crank. So the faster the engine is going, the faster the pump is rotating, the higher the oil pressure. So at low RPMs, the oil pressure is substantially lower. Now, normally that shouldn't be too much of a problem. That's been designed into engines. But in some engines, it can lead to oil starvation. The manufacturers have not taken into account the fact that this engine is always going to be driven at low RPMs. You need the range of RPMs, and that gives an opportunity to get that lubrication to all the different parts of the engine. So you're creating an artificial environment there that the manufacturer hasn't taken into account. Even on engines where you have a variable flow oil pump, you can have serious problems at low RPMs. I think it was the 3-litre TDI V6 engines that the Volkswagen Group recently introduced with this. They wanted to save fuel, and one way of doing that was to effectively underdrive the oil pump at low RPMs. And that was causing problems with poor lubrication, but only for drivers that were always at the low RPM range. The oil pump never kicked up to the level where it was delivering enough pressure to lubricate the entire engine. And that was effectively leading to oil starvation. Now, I think in that particular case, it can be mitigated to some extent with an adjustment in the ECU that just drives that oil pump harder. But again, you might think you're protecting the engine by driving at low RPMs, when actually, in that case, you're causing serious damage to the engine through poor lubrication. So at low RPMs, the engine is working inefficiently. It's producing more soot that's a byproduct of incomplete combustion. And that's going to cause problems elsewhere in the engine. It's going to go into the intake. We've discussed carbon deposits on the intake, particularly on modern direct injection engines. So with low RPM driving, everything in the engine, the air going into it and the exhaust gases coming out, are also moving more slowly. There's less happening with each revolution of the engine. So items like your catalyst and your particulate filter are going to clog up more quickly. The low RPM inefficient combustion process is probably going to dump unburnt fuel into the catalyst, which is going to play havoc on the lifespan of the catalyst itself. But this inefficient burn can also play havoc as the carbon particles enter these and add to the clogging up that you get. And that really makes the problem worse. The more buildup there is inside the engine, the more clogged up everything is getting with carbon, the less effective and efficient the engine is, the more dirty it burns, and you're in that loop where the situation is just running away with itself and things are just getting worse. So a lot of people do talk about the Italian tune-up, but there's certainly a lot of truth in exploring the upper range of the RPM power band just to keep everything flowing. The faster RPMs mean more air is being shifted through the engine. The engine's going to be running slightly hotter because there's more combustion events going on in the engine, and that is going to lead to burning off carbon deposits. The carbon is going to break off. Obviously, that can cause problems in certain situations, but if you've maintained the engine with these bursts of power and high RPMs, it goes a long way to preventing a lot of these issues from building up and becoming a problem. So low RPM driving often is equated with driving slowly, but that's not always the case. You can do low RPMs at relatively quick road speed. So potentially overheating. Now, you might think at low RPMs, the engine is working less and it's going to be producing less heat, but there's less air going through the engine bay, less air going through the radiator. There is a fan, so that should cut in and pull more air in. But the low RPM driving is inefficient. The engine tends to run hotter in those situations at low RPMs than it would be at the higher RPMs. And that's especially true if you're using more throttle. And obviously, sometimes you have to compensate with the low RPMs by using more throttle to make these adjustments in speed, because you have a bigger adjustment in speed and the car's not responding to the light throttle inputs that you would get if you were in the correct gear. And by compensating for that, you're putting more fuel into the engine, and that can lead to these overheating problems. But also the water pump, if it's driven by the crank, is rotating more slowly. The circulation within the engine is more slow. So the water inside the engine is getting hotter. So this heat can eventually warp components. It can damage head gaskets. It can cause metal fatigue, and metal parts can actually start to fail through this extreme expansion of heat. So basically then, driving at low RPMs won't damage your engine unless that's all you do. It is so good to vary the RPMs and use the full range of RPMs and choose a correct gear. So a correct gear does not mean the one that uses the least amount of fuel and keeps the RPMs as low as possible, because that can be a situation where you're building up problems for yourself that are going to cost you a lot more money in the long run than the fuel you're actually saving. So it's a bit of a curse of hypermilers. This driving style where you keep the RPMs as low as possible can lead to big, expensive repair bills that are avoidable. So just get in your car, enjoy it, use the full range of RPMs. So be conscious as to your gear selection. If you need to accelerate and you're in too low a gear, don't expect the car to compensate for everything. Drop down a gear and use the power then. Make sure the car is actually in the power band that the manufacturer designed, and everything should then work efficiently and you'll be getting the best from your engine and adding to its long-term reliability. So thanks for watching. Please boot that like button, because that really does help us to get out there. I've lined this video up for you, and if you haven't subscribed, we'd love you to stay tuned. So please subscribe to the channel. That really does help us out. Thanks for watching. See you in this next video.